This is the one from 2023. We have a function with all these conditions. Part A says we are going to find the fourth derivative of the function at zero. And then after that, we need the fourth degree Taylor polynomial of the function at x equals zero. Starting with this, the fourth derivative is just that we will have to differentiate the third derivative, which is negative 2x times f prime of x squared. Here we will have to use the product rule. I will keep the first function times the derivative of the second. Derivative of f prime is f double prime. That's the second derivative. Yeah. And then use the chain rule, multiply by the derivative of the inner function. So that will give us the 2x here. And then we add the second function just as how it is, and then multiply by the derivative of the first. Derivative of negative 2x is negative 2. Then you can simplify this a little bit, or you can just plug in through into all the x's. Doesn't really matter. I will simplify this a little bit though. This times this, we get negative 4x squared times f double prime of x squared, and then minus 2, and then f prime of x squared. Then I will plug in 0 into all the x's. So the fourth derivative at 0 equals negative 4 times 0 squared times f double prime of 0 squared minus 2 times f double, so just prime of x, which is 0, and square that. Firstly, this is 0, so multiply, you get 0. And then minus 2 times f prime of 0 is 3. So we multiply that by 3. Negative 2 times 3, we get negative 6. And then we are done. Now, continue. We need a fourth degree Taylor polynomial, which we pretty much have to do this right here. We need a derivative divided by n factorial and then multiply by x minus the center and then to the nth power. Firstly, though, we need the value of the function at 0, which is just 2. And then we need the first derivative at 0, which is 3. And then divided by 1 factorial times x minus 0, which is just x now, and then to the first power. This means the center, right? X minus a sometimes. And then continue, we need the second derivative, which we have to work that out from here. So f double prime of 0 equals negative f of 0 squared. This is just 0, and then f of 0 is 2, so we have negative 2. So for the second derivative, we have negative 2, and then divided by 2 factorial, and then do x to the second power. Then we need the third derivative at 0, so f triple prime of 0 equals negative 2 times 0 times f prime of 0 squared. Thanks to this 0, everything is 0. You don't really have to write that down. It's plus 0 divided by 3 factorial x to the third power, which is 0. Lastly, we need the fourth derivative, which is negative 6, over 4 factorial times x to the fourth power. Now we can just simplify it and it will be done. 2 is 2. 1 factorial is 1, so 3 divided by 1, that's just 3x. This is 2 times 1, which is 2. 2 divided by 2 is just 1, and then it's the minus x squared. And for the 4 factorial, this means 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is 24. 6 divided by 24 is 1 over 4, and here we have a minus 1 over 4 x to the 4th power. And this is it. Now for part B, and I think the AP test really likes to ask either the Lagrange error bound questions or the alternating series error bound questions, so make sure you know both. Here, we use the Lagrange. We want to show that the fourth degree Taylor polynomial approximation, to f of 0.1 is going to be good within 1 over 10 to the fifth power. To do so, we first set it like this. This is our approximation, and this is the actual value. We subtract, and then we put that in the absolute value. We want to show that this right here is less than or equal to, and here's the Lagrange error bound formula. This right here is a fourth degree Taylor polynomial. So right here, you want to get the maximum of the fifth derivative. So it's one more than that. I will use the same notation on the official scoring guide. So I will just say maximum. And we care about the interval when x is in between of 0 and, because we go to 0.1, right? So 0.1. And then absolute value, and here is the fifth derivative. And then divided by the bottom is one more than that. Again, so it'll be 5. And then factorial. And then right here, you multiply by the x value, which is 0.1. And then the center right here is 0, so just 0.1. And then raised to the fifth power. So if this is a 4, then it'll be 5, 5, 5. And this right here, you just replace the usual derivative with the maximum of the fifth derivative and then absolute value of that. Yeah. So that's pretty much a setup. Now the rest is just do the computation. This right here, it's actually given right here. Less than or equal to this number, so the 15 is the maximum. They give us the interval from 0 to 0.5, which is good because here we just need from 0 to 0.1. So this right here, it's going to be less than or equal to, here we have 15, because it says so, and then over 5 factorial, which is just 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, you get 120 times this right here, that's ready as a fraction, which is 1 over 10 raised to the 5th power. Now, check this out. Because we want to show that this thing is less than 1 over 10 to the 5th power, right? So in fact, if you take a look right here, 15 over 120 is less than 1. So in fact, we can just ignore that and then say that's less than this right here, which is 1 over 10 to the 5th power. I know this right here is less than 1, but on the official scoring guide, they put it down as less than or equal to. So this is all you have to show. Now for part C, we are given another function g, so that g of 0 is equal to 4, and g prime of x is equal to e to the x times f of x. And we are going to find the second degree Taylor polynomial for g at x equal to 0. So you know, we will have to get the derivatives for g first at 0. To do so, here we see that g prime of 0 is just going to be e to the 0 times f of 0, and that is just 1 times this right here is 2, so that will be 2. Okay, then we need to get the second derivative. So look at this and differentiate. G double prime of x equal to the derivative of e to the x times f of x. Use the product rule here, so we get the first function times the derivative of the second, and then we add a second function times the derivative of the first, and then plugging 0. So g double prime of 0 equals e to the 0 times f prime of 0 plus f of 0 times e to the 0's power. E to the 0 is just 1, and this right here is equal to 3, so we have 1 times 3, and then plus f of 0 is 2 times 1. So altogether we get 5. Now, this right here, t2 of x, and this right here is for g, and center the at 0 again. So I'll just say at x equals 0. First, we need the value of the function, which is 4. And then we add the next thing, which is the first derivative, which is 2, and divided by 1 factorial, times x to the first power. It's 5. Now, we have all the ingredients to answer this question. T2 of x will be g of 0, which is 4, and then we add the first derivative at 0, which is 2, and divide it by 1 factorial, and then x to the first power, and then continue, plus the second derivative, which is 5, divided by 2 factorial, and then x squared. Simplify this a little bit, we get 4 plus 2x plus 5 over 2 factorial, just 2, and then x squared. So this right here will be it.